Hey there, Yang here. Today we're going to talk a little bit about the writing system, the plans I'm having with it, and how it basically came together. So a few years back, I created a writing system for a single player. Basically get up, get off with the mount animations with it. So this website will go down in a few months, so everything is transferred to my Discord. So I'm gonna take the PDF version, so I created a PDF version out of it where you can then follow along. And then in the end, you will be having this one. In the end, you will be having this. Let me see where it opens. So this was really, and basically the why. Basically why I started it is my boy. Oh, this guy. Yeah, this guy. This guy came with the character, but it also included the horse, and it's basically the asset you got, the models you got, animations included, animations, basic animations, to get you started. But there's no blueprint, there's nothing for riding a horse or anything. So that was basically the starting point from beginning the riding system. Also, at that point, I came from Unity to Unreal, so I had to learn everything from scratch. As in the beginning, I started, like you see, to use the visual scripting language of the Epic Engine. A little bit of C++ also learning. Now coming from Unity and then having C#, the if else situation stays if else. Okay, how you write it is different. That's for all the languages. You know, if you take Lua, PHP, or whatever, if else is if else, simple. If you got the logic of that, then it's just getting used to writing it in that language, let me say. And then, yeah, also understanding what you're doing. So I'm gonna drag in the old project where I was testing, like at this point, like you see, first of all, the writing itself. The writing itself, and then from the writing, I start from, like here you see, this is a model I created myself, and I build it normally. You see, put game on, click back on it. So I was thinking for a survival game, my Ali point of view, I was thinking to have it pulled by the character or have it pulled by the animal. That was the first thing. So I created a well, and I starting to figure out how you can best correct and attach things to something else. Here the same, I created a wagon. The wagon is also same like the well. You need to do the physics, and at this point, like I say, it's really starting learning, starting a beginner project, let me say, and how do you create a vertical, and how do you manage to get that stick together without flying in the air like you don't know what. So I'm gonna quickly take a play, if I still remember, with buttons. So this is, you see, like over there, you saw him flying. So that physics is totally messed up. Let me think how I did it, because sometimes, is it M? This is, yeah, this is M. So this one, if you look at the head, so it's also influenced the animation blueprint. You see, the character moves, it's not 100%. Okay, then again, we go off. That is the writing. And I think I need to have, I placed them wrong because that will be a little bit different. Hold on, I'm going to try to position them. Long time ago. Something like that, I think it was. Hold on. And then I think, was it F2? Hold on. Was it 2? Yeah, I don't remember. 1, 2, 3, no? Yeah, I don't remember what the connection key was, but it connects and you can pull the wagon. But the wagon itself, like what I was testing, I remembered. Where are they? There. Well, gonna speed up a little bit. Zip. So, there must be wagons around here somewhere. There, no? Yeah. So, what I was testing, just my test environment to see what is happening. Oh, yeah, that's why I put it on multiplayer. Now, you see, I was testing the physics of my wagon. That is what I was doing around here. But to keep it a little bit shorter, so okay, I was doing this. That is maybe, I think, 2 years ago or something. And then I led it a little bit, to be honest. I was doing some other stuff. And then I came back to it. But then, like you see, I was trying to do it in multiplayer, but yeah, that totally didn't work. Like the setup is here. So it's not, if you're gonna use this one, you will be having a lot of work to get it multiplayer. So I'm gonna close this guy. Don't save anything before we break. This also can be done. Then a few years later, so last year I think it was, I started on recreating the rider system, but then more in mind of having it not directly sit on the character, as in character itself, and another character in this case, that is the horse. I tried to build it like with components. So I have a rider component and I have a, sorry, a mount component. So I think if I keep this logic or this thinking and using components, I think in later on, if I share this project, it will be much better to just add the components to your character. So I assume you have already a surviving game, and that is the thing you don't have in it, and you just want to have it ride something. Then you just need to add the components, add the interfaces, and take the mount. Let me see where it opens. It opens correctly. Viewport. So I, in this case, I am using a deer for the copyrights. I cannot use my native American, or I cannot use the NM horse set. So, but yeah, I'm using the default Epic deer. So like you see, I built it up already. So we have the deer, we have the enter trigger. This could change in what I'm going to explain later. So yeah, we have the deer, and then yeah, you see it's not working. Then, you know, this is just testing it. This, also the same thing. We have our character. I was testing shooting and shit, but yeah, okay. Then we have the rider component, so like you see. And it's not much basically, when you look at it, what we got, it's you got like a default. Probably opens in the wrong screen. You have like you see the animation blueprint, normal things. Like here, I still do casting. Like I'm more tend in using interfaces at this point, and instead of the casting situation. So I create. I'm making myself the habit, let me say, when I'm working in blueprints, to create an interface per class I'm doing. And then it could be simple way from only returning the character instead of casting. Okay, then I think here, let me quickly look how we did it here. So we have this, we have the default slot, otherwise it's not playing montages. And then yeah, we have only here the on horse. The on horse is set on horse, the not on horse. It comes from a structure. It selects the idle animation and it plays the idle animation. So basically nothing much in going on in the animation blueprint for now. Let me quickly see. We take the rider that we store around here. So what I'm saying here is basically on the update, check if we have a valid rider. If it's valid, just continue. If it's not valid, then we cast and get the rider, set the rider, and then we continue with the logic. We take the on horse boolean from the rider. And we set this to the on to the boolean that we need to have here. Okay. And then this is just the regular movement is in the air. Then here we have like the speed and the direction. So for controlling the rider when he is on the horse. Okay, so basically nothing much. Simple. But like you see on the rider, we have two interfaces. This I'm gonna also in what I'm doing now, I'm gonna take everything and then I'm gonna see what is needed, what can I reduce and stuff like that, so that it's cleaner, let me say. Then we have some functions. Yeah, you see, shoot, we have some functions. Then we have the interface that is set. So again, according to the movement basically, but that I think I'm gonna, hold on, that I think I'm gonna do. I think it's quicker to take the PDF version. Let me quickly look where is it? Where did I drop that guy? There's a function in here. That's the anime. Here, this guy. This part is basically when you're sitting on the horse, that he updates the speed and direction to the horse, so that the horse moves along. That is basically, but that is what I'm gonna now do. I'm gonna take some elements from the single player, so this guy, and I also will take the structure of this project. Okay, so that is the riding system in its total. We're gonna now talk enough about this. I'm gonna open. Yeah, look. If I do, well, we gotta do first one. If I do like this, yeah, you see, okay, single game. Okay, that's a single game. Yeah, don't watch the count. The box is this side. Is the box this side? Yeah, the box is this side. press E. Voila. Same thing again. We get on. We drive a little bit. This one doesn't do the animation blueprint for the moment. Then again, we go. Just get off. Voila. Stop playing. Then I'm gonna take this guy and do it like so. The test map directly. And the other one opens there, close it like so, put it like there, drop this guy somewhere around here. Take first the client, yeah, that is because he's shooting him. It was this side. Yeah, we go press the E, you see, on both screens. It is running around. You see it on the other screen also. Then E. And you get off. So that is basically at the moment the end result of the component multiplayer riding system. But then the other crazy thing came. So like I say, this is the complete blueprint version. I'm gonna quickly go to my Discord. There it is. So on my Discord, I have a file. So this file is basically this project. What you see, like it is. Okay? So now, as I want to go back to my C++, because I lost too much in coding by using the blueprints, but now I need to really think backwards basically, because what we see here is modern scripting. The bare bones of everything comes from C++, so it doesn't matter what you take, it's always got some relation into C++. So it's better, in my opinion. I'm studying the Epic engine for quite a while now, and I think it's better to say, even if some say no, but I think if you're going to create a real game that will have some out of the box or not out of the box situations, that it's better to learn a little bit of C++. That is what I learned about the engine, even if some say you can perfectly do everything in blueprints, like I did here. Yes, perfectly possible, but I'm also following still some other courses doing it. So I sometimes buy me one and I just do them just to see how they approach things. But then I came to one for verticals, because I don't know much about verticals and everything. So I took me a course about verticals, and then all of a sudden I say like, oh boy, what is this? So he start by modifying the engine for the physics, and then he needs to do this and that, and I'm like, oh boy, man, that for just driving a car, you know. But I understand them, I correctly understand them. And why I correctly understand them is basically, if I go back to my library, so yeah, you see I have a lot of that. So look here, you have the vertical system. Nice, eh? It's a nice system, eh? It's yeah, and it got like even a small AI that follows the pattern and stuff. It's in the external project, but it's simple. This is really simple. It doesn't have destruction in it. It doesn't have, but it comes with some nice car examples. The build for the car works pretty good, quick, to be honest. But the result, you know, the end result, like I have a car, and the moment I starting to speed up, even with those, the moment I'm starting to speed up and I'm starting to corner and everything, no, you cannot do like a curbstone turning with the cars. It's impossible. So okay, doesn't matter, right? We're still looking at what we got and what we can do with it, eh? And then you have like, where is it? Oh, here, like those guy, and we'll take the main part. So this guy, he got like the, where is it? You have like this one, the multiplayer one. That is just the expansion. You have the default. Where is it? Of course, when you need it, it's not there. Well, here you have the basic. It comes in an asset, and this is the basic with all the blueprints and everything. So that is really the basic. Then you also have like I say, the multiplayer. And then you also have like two other packs, the essential and the advanced pack. Yeah, I got most of them. But this is a complete other system. It comes with destruction. Not destruction like yesterday, a friend of me gave me a YouTube video of a project that really was destruction. But this is also multiplayer. Directly comes with basically entering the vehicle, and it does this pretty nice. So not by just flipping you to the door and opening the door and flipping you inside the car. No, you got really like walking to the car, opening the door, go sit on both sides. So no, that is really done well. So to come back to our riding thing, so what I'm doing now, I'm going to rebuild this. I already started it, but I'm gonna rebuild this exactly like it is now. But this time, I'm going to do it in C++. Yeah, nice. Hold on, my in the wrong screen. I'm gonna launch it quickly. So yeah, don't get scared now. Huh? So what I did, started like this. So I started to take everything from this project, every element, and I put it in a C++ file. In this, or this current moment, what I got is basically the, I take this guy for example. So here, no, that was not correct. I'm gonna take the component. So what I'm now doing is, or what I did already, this. So I started to look, what do we got? We got the online on-ramp modifiers. Yeah. For the rest, not really functions in it. We still have our interface that is at this point only initializing the controller. That is not set here. That is set on the rider. So that function needs to go here. So I'm going to also take everything out of the player. Trying, I'm going to try to take everything out of the player so that there's totally nothing on the player that maybe except an interface that you need to configure and add a component, but not set like a whole bunch of variables. I'm going to rip that out of the character and I'm going to put that in the components itself. So what I'm doing, so like you can see here, I'm recreating this, all these events. Not the code behind it. I didn't do anything with the code behind it, but only the events that I need. And like you see, it's all multiplayer, these ones, eh? So yeah, I'm learning, but we will see. So at the moment, so like I say, I'm gonna close this guy completely now, and I'm gonna launch this guy. We'll open in the other screen. Yeah, that is the code behind it, so we don't need that. Here we are, this C++ writing system. So, like you see, this is the blueprints. I'm gonna do it a little bit different, so I'm gonna only use the character as the player. So the writer will be coming from the character class. But the animal, I created a base pawn class. So I basically what I did is launched this guy, new C++ character, next, next, next. And the only thing I did was prefix it with DP underscore, Derek Peters underscore. That's the only thing I did on this guy. I don't even think that there's something configured except the component. The component is configured on the base file. Then from this, hold on, quickly look on my, and I said this guy I need, and I got a scheme, this guy, is it opening? Okay, it's opening correctly, so I'm gonna launch it. So like I'm explaining, I quickly created like all like I'm gonna explain. So the writing system, the C++, all classes will have interfaces implementation by default, like I'm doing in blueprints, even if it only returns the reference to that class, doesn't matter, it's for the casting. Then I prefix everything, like I say, with DP underscore, and these are just the main things at the moment. So character class we got, like I say, the character will hold the writer component. Then the intention is to make an NPC and the player character base. We're talking about base files and not the end player or the end NPC. Then for pawn, we do the same, create a new one, prefix it, add the mount component to it. We're gonna make the mount and we're gonna make the vertical base. So I'm intending to do, I already did it on another project, so I'm gonna merge a little bit all those projects together. So I have a working enter car, drive the car, and also with the horse, so that I got. The only difference you gotta between those two, a car, most games, there will be games that have more things, but basically you go to the car, you press the key, you enter the car. Many of the games even don't come with an animation of opening the door and nicely go sit in the car. It just like switch you from one point to another. Some even directly connect the player inside the car and work with hide and visible by when you press, he destroys the player, possess the car, and then makes the driver visible. Same like on the horses and animals. Some do it like that, but this is not done. This is really keeping your character possessing or attaching you to the vertical or the, but this also, and that's what I need to look into, because you have verticals, you just get in and you drive and you get out. You can have passengers and stuff like that. But this one, you sit on the animal. If it's just like a funny walk to the park, then it's okay, like it is now. Even you can download it, you can drop it in your game, you configure it, and you can have your walk in the park. But then I want to shoot when I sit on the horse. I want to be able to shoot a gun. I want to be able to shoot a bow. I want to be able to take my sword and his head off and you know, all those crazy things. Then this setup will not work. Why? Because we are possessing the horse in this case, and we're streaming the speed and the direction to the rider, so the animation plays for the rider. If I want to shoot like this now, then I need to put a shoot function over here. I need to trigger the player and so on. So I was doing some tests. So I was testing with not possessing, same like you do in the vehicle when a passenger comes. He is not possessed the car, only the driver will possess the car. So in this case, and that is why I was talking about that update speed and direction function, like now it's set up on the rider. No, it needs to be set, excuse me, needs to be set on the horse. We want the rider to attach to the horse and send in the speed and the direction to the horse. That is the only thing. The horse need to walk, the horse need to jump, the horse need to turn right, turn left. That's the only thing the horse need to do. The horse doesn't need to shoot a gun. The horse doesn't need to hack his head off with the, okay, you can have an attack, but where is the logic sitting on a horse that performs an attack? What attack can a horse do? If you have horses in real life, you know a horse can kick you with all his legs. He can even kick you sideways. Like most people think it's like a wooden thing. He can only hit you from behind. No, don't test it. A big horse, when you stand next to him, 1 meter, he will have you sideways. Believe me. Same with the front legs. What can he do with the front legs? He can hack you. Like when you harvesting a tree, like he can hack you in the back, bang, at the hospital. Or he can go up and hit you on the, but he can hit with the front legs. That's the only thing. But he will not do this when you're riding and you're shooting and the horse just walks and falls on the ground when he's dead or something. But he will not start attacking you the moment you sit on it. Then you have a bad horse, simple as that. So we need to be realistic and we need to make sure that the player can all do all these things. So, and then later on, also once this is completely working, we will then start by looking into how we can easily do all those actions when we sit on the horse. Even look into it when, for example, on the vehicle, you have an open Jeep, I don't, and you sit in the back, for example, that you maybe be able to take your gun and shoot from out of the back of the car or something. We will see. We will see how, and then also, I'm gonna do it in C++, so I will prototype maybe in Blueprint, and but then I need to convert the code into C++, so that will be a hell of a task. But yeah, it doesn't matter. Then we come to the other classes, so the main parts basically. Could be, I don't know. I'm gonna see how these two work together in setting up this, so that we don't need to have like a list of components before everything is working. Then same thing with as you see, like I put everywhere component interface on it. So this component interface is mounted to this guy, and no, it's yeah, it's mounted to this. So that's correctly. This goes there, this goes there. The image is not correct, but that is the thing. And then same for the player controller and the AI controller, they will all so have its own interface. So this I created thinking further wise. This I created because we have it in the other project and it's doing stuff. So I need this. And then also for the game state, the game mode, the instance, those things you need to have by default in your game. I just did the create class at the prefix. Nothing is filled in. So voila. Now, how far am I at this point? I am at this point. I created the base classes, like the character, the mount, like you see. So that is already done. I also added the interfaces. For now, what I think I need, but I need to look like I have test code my interface just to learn how you do all those things, because yeah, blueprint, it's easy. You just go here, uppercase, blueprint, interface, bang, fill it in. Same for the structures, bang, enums, bing, and there you fill it in, and they are there. That's not the case in C++. So that is a little bit more headache. But it doesn't matter. So to come back then, like I say, we have the components. Go back to the C classes because that's the map we need. The controllers, AI, player. I try to directly put everything nice in order. Core, like I say, core, the instance, the game state bay, the players, the save game also. Could be that it be deleted later on. The HOD file I also created. These are just the regular, like what you got in your project, but you the same thing you would do when you work in Blueprints, create those personalized project files. Okay, and then the yeah, that is something because I was doing a racing game, so I was thinking that could be interesting also. So that I also gonna do, and then later on, yeah, we will then have a little bit more, like a wagon, for example. Maybe I go look because the wagon you saw in the first series. That is one I created myself in 3D Studio Max. It got some UV problems but it's for testing, it's okay. But yeah, like I say, you need to really do the physics and everything. So I'm gonna see. Maybe I'm gonna recreate that wagon to be used here. So we can set it up really with the physics, and I can leave it in the project to share with you later on then. Maybe I put it on the marketplace. I don't know. I will see what I'm gonna do with it. But at this point, we are going to try building this. And I'm gonna close this and I'm gonna go back to the C++ thing. So like you say, like you see, I'm starting already. So this is basically setting up the mount component. So that is the interface of the mount component, like you see. Same thing like in Blueprint, set owning player, it returns a reference of your created pawn. I keep the base class, but this maybe is not a good idea. This is not a good idea. I was just thinking on it yesterday. I think I need to change these guys. And I think I need to change them to the epic classes. I think that will be better in the sense of when I share the project and you start from also same thing like we do, I start from the epic character. I think it's better to use the epic character and then use the interfaces itself, or whatever, or test that you come to the character that you need. But I think for sharing and And have you integrate this into your own project without needing to modify everything? I think it's better maybe to put them to the pawn class on the actor class, and but I will see. I will see. I'm gonna write the code, gonna make sure that the functionality works. The only thing I'm a little bit afraid of is the networking. And hold on, I'm gonna look. Which one? Think. Hold on, I'm looking at. Bum, bum, bum. Yeah, this one. I'm passing you see, like. But I need to know because, yeah, that's because you work in blueprints and you bang, click on the variable, go in the palette. Is a notifier. He creates that function and he fill in the function. But here, yeah, I'm looking and yeah, when I don't see the same things visually, exactly the same. Let me say, like these doesn't come. If I'm opening it again, you will see. It's on the writing component. Yeah, writing component. So yeah, this is really pure testing. So writing component. It was this guy. This guy. Oh shit! Idiot. This guy. I'm opening the zipper as well. Like you see, normally here, you need to have like I'm gonna quickly do one. Then you go like that notify, and you see he create that function. See? And then you go in the function, and you say like print. Basic stuff, just print. So every time you change this guy, he will print. I'm working. Okay, simple, eh? One, two, three, ready. Now, no. That is not the case in good here, so I really need to study why. It's not displaying like it is in the first place. And I think I already, yeah, like you see, same thing what I did now. I create the onWrap. I print a log statement to see if my function is working. Same thing on all the functions. So that is what I'm doing now, basically creating the functions. Put a log in it, and then once that is working, then I will continue. But like you see, yeah, and I really need to learn a lot again. Lost a lot, and then like the networking, yeah, that is not that easy in C++. But again, they say if you're going to make a multiplayer game, you benefit from it when you know a little bit of, or when you can read C++. If you don't can read C++, yeah, then it's basically a Dutch guy reading a Chinese book. It's just the same. Okay, so that is basically what I'm going to do. Thank you for watching. Leave a comment, I would say, what you think about it. You can come into the Discord and we can discuss and make this a nice project. Basically, you can, if you already have like C++ knowledge and you're willing to help, I don't say that you need to provide me with code or anything, just yeah, put me in the correct flow, let me say, like I'm doing now. I have some good references because these are The bad thing in following courses for Unreal, when you go on, this is not really to judge people, but to be honest, and hold on, I'm going to go. Going to go to the Udemy site. This is just one. And then you can type like Unreal Engine. Yeah. What do we got? And then you can start like here, look at the prices. Look at the prices. If I tell you that basically none of these tutorials, but really none, talk about saving. Saving, a crucial thing in your game. Saving your data. None talk about it. Maybe some. That is just the beginning. Game states. Modes, some. But game states, all those files. Nobody talks about them. There's nobody in the C++ courses that is talking about using interfaces. How do you set up the structs correctly? All those crucial things is not talked about it. And if you then see the prices, hey guys, are you out of your mind? And they make a lot of money, and believe me, they don't have them only here. They got them like on, what is it, PoolSign and Teachable and you name it. Okay, if you know a little bit your way around Udemy, you also know like they promote it. So this course is now at the moment 11.99. This is how Udemy works. Never go directly on the price you see. Register, wait, you will get an advertisement that this particular course will be 11 or 12 euros. But still, it's not what I want. When I learn, I want to learn correctly, and I want to know. I don't want to have a fancy game that is missing crucial things. This one is a very good one, to be honest, but I got most of the courses, and that's why I also say it like I now had, which one was it? Hold on, here this, which one was it? Here, this guy. You think I'm gonna follow this course and he will explain me how we are building a vehicle? No, what he is doing is provide you with files, yeah? Provide you with files completely during his course. You don't type basically one line of code, and then in the end you say like, yeah guys, the content from the course is copyright protected, even the code is copyright protected, and blah 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 blah. Okay, you have the code. You can learn from it. 100% agree. But in the end, first of all, if you begin here on this course, that's why I stopped this one. I need to really update my C++ because some parts are Chinese, like I say. But in the end, it's always the same. Always the same. If you go on YouTube, you start following. We are building a survival game with the inventory system and with this and that and blah 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 blah. And in the end, then when you watch the last video in the playlist and you check the comments, hey, when is the inventory thing coming out? When is this coming out? And 2 years later, it's still the same. You know? It's still the same. You end up with a lot of projects that are unfinished, totally unfinished. Or you need to pay for it, but in my really, in the during all these years, buying courses and everything, no. When you really start on Epic, I would suggest you to mainly stay on YouTube and those things, because you can learn a lot of from them. Be specific, really be specific in your search when you type in Google. Don't try to type it in what you want to do. And look, when versions, yes, you have difference in the engine versions and everything, but mainly the logic stays the same. You just need to adapt you to the new, yeah, features that the engine comes with. It's for everything like that. When you start learning designing websites 20 years ago, or you start learning it now, it's completely different. So, and that is for everything basically. So, no, I would say leave a comment, come to Discord and we can talk about it. But this is basically what I'm going to do now. My series of the Ascent Combat Framework and all those things, I'm gonna leave for now, because there's a lot of study. Also, I'm a little bit in bad papers if it comes to my health situations at the moment. To give you an idea, my body is fighting a little bit against me for over 2 years now, producing a lot of stones in my kidneys. They every time need to be removed by a surgery. So, to give you an idea, I have like at the moment 12 surgeries on a time period of 2 years. Painful situations, and that is what I mean. If I need to go to the toilet 3 times in a row, the rest of the day, all my energy will be lost. I cannot do anything. I'm laying on the sofa. So, that is, if you see sometimes big gaps between videos or something, that is mainly the reason why you have those gaps. Okay? So, again, I will see you in the next video. This will be then more like a development overview instead of a tutorial. Maybe I will create a tutorial how I build up the blueprint version of the riding system if somebody is interested. But yeah, okay, leave it then in the comments and I will look what I can do. See you next time. Bye bye.